Let's get it. You down with OCC?
Yeah, you know it.
You down with OCC?
Yeah, you know it.
You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know it.
You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know it.
Hey. Man, it feels so good to be back, man. I needed this.
That shit ride.
One more time, one more time. You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know it.
You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know it.
You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know it.
You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know way.
Hey, fade it out, fade it out, fade it out. Hey, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of the Real Creators Collab, the RCC podcast. We back in the lab. This is your boy Marcus, aka I am Dr. Carter G. Woodson. If you don't know, do your Googles. Learn your history. This is Black History Month.
Black History Month.
Learn who started this. Who pushed for this? All right.
It's your boy Levert, aka Leverticus, aka Sweet Dick Willie. I'm feeling good, man. How you feeling?
Man, I'm feeling good. But before we get started, I want to say happy birthday, Trayvon Martin. He would have been 26 this year if it wasn't for fucking niggas in the world. Yeah, he would have been 26 this year.
Wow. That's crazy.
Bruh, I'm, man.
How long has this been since his death?
I want to say next year, so it's 9 years. I want to say next year will be 10 years since he was murdered. By a coward.
Bro, time is flying, and every year somebody else is taken from us.
Yeah, I mean, we can go down a whole dark, morbid path, but just, man, just continue to keep his family in his prayers. Keep the families of all these victims in your prayers, man. But just happy birthday to that man. We'll uplift him. We'll celebrate with him. Just happy birthday, Trayvon Martin. He would have been 26.
Happy birthday, man.
Hey. But hey, man, you asked me how I was doing. I'm doing good, man. Hey, it's Friday.
Hey, it never feels like Friday, man, to me.
What you mean?
It just seems like days are running into each other, running together.
Oh, man, I definitely feel like Friday. Man, what's that, what's the 80s bop? It go like, doom, 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 doom. And it was like, just got paid. It's Friday night. Oh, man, I don't know who wrote that.
All right. Who's saying that song?
I don't even know who wrote that, man. But that's how I feel right now, man. Can't go no fucking way during the pandemic.
What, today was payday for you?
Fuck no. I wish though. But nah, man. That's how I feel right now. It's Friday. I got sleeping tomorrow. Don't got to do shit. Just focus on myself tomorrow. What about you?
Shit, I've been sleeping in pretty much every day. I mean, that's the life of, you know what I'm saying, not having like a 9-to-5 right now. But you know what? I actually enjoy it.
I mean, shit, I would too if I had nothing to do. I mean, you can focus on yourself. Do what you want
to
do.
Yeah, I mean, when I need to go make money, I go make money. But
exactly. I mean, like, how to say, in today, it's easy to go make a dime and make something happen.
You really do.
Flip a brick or something.
I mean, you gotta use, like, your attributes and your assets. Not saying I'm out here slanging, but I'm saying, like.
I mean, if you want to be a gigolo, it is what it is, baby.
I'm a gigolo.
Oh, bro, you heard they was bringing back Wildin' Out?
Is Nick coming back?
Nick coming back. Him and Viacom made up. He coming back. Wildin' Out coming back. I mean, I don't know.
Salute to Nick fucking Cannon.
Absolutely. I mean, I don't know if, I don't know if DC and Carlos and all them coming back, but the show coming back for sure. I mean, Nick stay putting on people on finding good talent, though.
Why wouldn't they come back? I mean, they got the sauce already going. Why would you change it up?
I mean, 85 South out here, they doing it big now.
Hell yeah. I mean, they got to come back.
Hey, I mean.
DC,
I mean, shit, I would like for Cat Williams to come back. I would like for Corey Holcomb and all them boys to come back.
I just want to see DC versus Cat Williams. That'd be a good one.
Man. Wow. That's a roast session. That's a roast session right there.
But you know what? I guarantee you Cat would take that shit, though.
Why you say that? DC go get that man a run for his money, man. DC, I mean, like, DC, man, DC just Atlanta, bro. Like, when I think of, like, Atlanta niggas roasting the fuck out of somebody, that's DC.
You don't think isn't Cat Williams from Atlanta too, or not?
I think Cat from somewhere down south.
Look,
and Kat, I apologize, Cat. Don't roast my ass if you is. I'm sorry.
Cat Williams is a legend, though.
Oh, I mean, Cat is a legend.
I mean, after you, I don't put nothing past Cat, and I would never like. I won't bet against Cat after that whole roast session he did with Wanda Smith
a couple years ago. Oh, bro. I felt so conflicted about this shit. I'm like, damn, he going in on that. This shit is hilarious.
I didn't feel any type of way because she asked for it because she was egging him on the entire time.
She was. I'm like, damn.
And plus, she's a comedian. So it's like, bro, like.
Hold on. I just thought she was a radio host. She a comedian too?
No, she's a comedian. That's why everybody was like, girl, you a comedian. Why you couldn't fight back?
Damn. Oh, wow. Now I feel different now.
No.
Then it's just jokes then.
It's all fucking jokes.
That's just jokes then.
Because she was trying to joke on him. He was like, he wasn't having that at first. Mm-hmm. He was like, he was chill. But he was like, you know what? Since you want it.
Exactly.
Since you came for me, girl, I'm coming back for you.
Don't come for me unless I send for you.
Exactly.
Bro, that shit was legendary. Hey, man, shout out Kat. Shout out DC. Shout out Nick. Yay. I'm happy to have Wildin' Out back.
When was that announced?
I think that was like in the last 48 hours.
That's dope.
Yeah.
Nah, I mean, money talks, bullshit walks.
I mean, we knew it was bullshit in the first place. I mean, they shouldn't have let him go. I mean, like, white people say, like, racist shit and get away with racist shit. Nick just spoke out of ignorance and, like, Viacom shut the whole shit down.
Yeah. Because what he was talking about.
I think it was something anti-Semitic.
Yeah, anti-Semitic.
Yeah.
It's crazy how that shit, like, depending on what you talk about, how they really check your ass.
Exactly.
Depending on, like, what they value or whatever, who's pushing the money. Follow the money, bro.
Hey, man, I won't even go down the rabbit hole because we might get anti-Semitic.
Nah, we cool on that shit.
Nah, man, but nah, I guess I do got to do something tomorrow. I got to start planning for Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day?
My first Valentine's Day. My first Valentine's Day as a husband.
Valentine's Day? When is Valentine's Day?
February 14th. It's like almost less than a week away, about a week away.
Oh, damn.
Why, you ain't got no boo?
Nah, I mean, I don't really. I never really fucked with Valentine's Day because I feel like it's so.
You don't fuck with pagan holidays?
Commercial. Like, that's the holiday where it's like, it's all that pressure that's put on men.
Absolutely.
For one single day. Like, you put your entire relationship in one single day, Valentine's Day?
Nah, a homeboy of mine, his birthday falls near Valentine's Day. And he was talking about how it ain't even. He don't even really get to celebrate his birthday. Because it kind of morphed into another his girl's birthday. It was like my birthday number two.
Man, fuck that shit.
Oh, man. But nah, yeah. Valentine's Day, that's a
but
scheme.
I would think, listen, if that's your birthday, like, I figure a birthday would trump Valentine's Day.
I mean, but we speaking from a male's point of view. We gotta understand.
Even with a woman's point of view, a good woman's point of view, like, really? You gonna, like, let Valentine's Day supersede his birthday?
Hey, man.
That's bullshit.
Hey. I mean, you know, shit happened. Shit happened. Nah.
So what's your plans? Like, have you started planning for it?
I mean, I've been asking what she wanted. She ain't told me.
Up.
Nah, I've been asking.
You know, as a woman, what she want, like.
Nah. What you mean? You know, Brett, this is 2021. You got to be clear, direct, and communicate with what your wants, needs, and aspirations.
No, she been.
You got to be specific with your prayer because God will give it to you. But you got to be specific with your prayer.
She been communicating with your ass just probably since y'all got together, probably within the last month or so, or maybe 2 months. Women, they just don't. They be giving you, like, hints and signals, like, ahead of time. They just looking for you to take heed and really notice it.
I mean, she told me she wanted to get married. We got married.
So that's your Valentine's Day gift?
Nah, man. I mean, I ain't gonna do that to them. I mean, you know, like, girls, you like, you ask a man, you'll ask her, what's my Valentine's Day gift? She'll be like, this pussy. And I'm like, this pussy, okay.
Ladies, the pussy is tired and old for these holidays. Don't try to repackage the pussy on these holidays. Hell no. Like, just like you want us to be thoughtful, you need to be thoughtful as well. And you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, we'll take us a little step back. If it's going to be the pussy, if it's going to be the pussy, at least, like, go out and get it manicured and, you know what I'm saying, shaped up, you know what I'm saying, like, with the landing strip and all of that. Make it look nice and maybe put, like, you can, like, put, like, a little bit more smell on it or something like that. Because if it's the same fucking box, bro, at least spice it up a little bit.
I mean, I know.
Get you some lingerie or some shit. Like, put it in a different box. Put your box in a different box.
It's my dick in a box.
Classic.
Nah, man. But, like you said, just be thoughtful, man. Pussy ain't always a gift. I mean, to a certain extent.
Oh, 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 I already hear him talking. Pussy is always a gift. What the fuck is he talking about?
Nah, I mean, pussy like dick is abundant in the world, man. It's out there.
It's abundant. But what's not abundant is good pussy and good dick.
That right there.
Look, ladies tell me all the time, like, you got all these men that's pretty much shortchanging them. And I'm like, what can you say? Like,
what is this? Freaky Friday.
No, but I'm just saying, like, all dick ain't and all pussy ain't created equal. You know what I'm saying? There's levels to this shit.
That's the truth. That's damn sort of true.
Yeah, so it's like, yeah, like, you, even with guys, like, yeah, you can repackage the dick all you want to. I think that should be just like a cherry on top. Like, every couple probably knows, like, we gonna probably get it in on Valentine's Day.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
That's a given. Just like, there was like this post on Facebook, and they were saying, like, when you go on vacation with your boo or whatever, do you expect sex? And as you in a relationship, would you be a person that would expect sex if you're going on vacation with your boo?
I mean, it really depends. Like, I've gone on vacations where, like, we just been doing so many fucking excursions and doing, like, just going out and traveling and seeing the world, seeing it, that, like, when we get back to the hotel room, we just fucking tired and want to sleep.
That's true.
But, I mean, but
you took a step back and y'all was just dating and say, like, you want to plan a trip with, like, your boo or whatever, go to a vacation.
Yeah.
If you get on a vacation and,
But, yeah. Like, if I go to Paris... Like, I'm going to Paris to fuck. Like, that's, like, I'm going to tell my kids, yeah, I fucked in Paris. I done fucked all over the world.
I'm just like, bro, like, y'all could have did a staycation if you wasn't getting no ass or whatever. Like, because I think, like, that adds to the actual trip. Like, the memories. Like, actually, we made love in Paris. We made love
exactly.
in these places. We fucked on this balcony or whatever. Like,
that's a movie.
That's a story. But if you get there, you're like, we traveled, we did all this. But then it's like, well, shit, y'all must have got it in when y'all was on y'all vacation. Nah, girl, we was too tired. Isn't a part of the vacation is to relax?
I guess part of it. I mean, but just...
I mean, maybe I'm thinking different. You let me know.
Nah, I mean, like, I ain't gonna go to, like, I'm not gonna go to, like, Mexico and not... I'm not gonna go to Egypt and not see the pyramids. Like, I'm gonna go do shit. But you're right.
Yeah, gonna do shit. But I'm like, I figured you would at least, like, plan that out. And I can understand, like, you being tired. Because I'm like, I say it all the time. Like, you get to a point, you have a long day. Sometimes we men don't be in a mood like that. And sometimes women still want to take the shit.
you feel like a prisoner, like a slave, sex slave.
Yeah, like, cause I mean,
no.
I mean, sometimes your head don't even match. Your two heads don't be matching up, and like it's got a mind of its own. Like, she played with a little bit, and then it's like,
okay.
Nah, I'm just saying, like, you in the bed, like, and normally if you're in the bed, you probably sleep. I mean, I sleep naked. Like, I don't. It's not. I sleep in the nude. Like, that, there's no other way. I've been doing that for years. Like, there's the only way to sleep. It's for me, it's to sleep nude. So it's like, if I'm with my girl or whatever, and you know how they do, where they start backing the ass up and like they want some. Oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like,
They want you to get in them guts when they do the booty poke.
That's what I'm saying. So it's like, if she start hitting that trick and you like, I'm so tired, but she gonna try to force her ass on you.
Hey, man, that's hilarious. Nah, but you
maybe, well, maybe, okay. Maybe the backup plan could be, if you're too tired, get her like her own sex toy.
Bro, this is like a brainstorming session.
I'm just saying, like, yeah, just get her own sex toy. Like, baby, like, I can't really service you right now, but I just bought something just for you.
Well, like the like a magic wand or like I can't get no shit that, you know, but you know they got some shit out here that'll damn near replace you.
Rock your world.
Replace you. I ain't trying to get a nothing that good.
I think that would be, I mean, even if we talk about Valentine's Day gifts, that'd be a thoughtful gift.
Absolutely.
Like some spicy shit. I don't like boring shit. Yeah. So it's like, I think they got those underwear or panties, whatever.
The vibrating ones?
The vibrating ones. Yeah. That you can actually control from your phone.
Yeah. Adam and Eve, if you want to sponsor this section, your logo could go right here.
Yeah, so it's like, be thoughtful. Look, because a lot of times what we think about, oh, I just need to get her some flowers. Oh, I need to get her some
flowers, candies, cards.
Simple shit. Yeah. Like, nah, get you some shit that don't have a fucking expiration date.
But thank you.
Or it depends on, like, the battery limit or whatever, but I'm just saying, rechargeable batteries and shit like that, like, be thoughtful, be spicy, be like, I think she'll actually enjoy it.
You said that until she's taking your Xbox batteries for your shit.
That's why you get a product that don't take the same type of batteries.
Double A, triple A.
Yeah, like, keep shit spicy and romantic, you know? And plus, I think it'll be dope, like, you spend the entire day together, and then she's actually wearing, like, the panties or whatever, y'all going out in public or whatever, maybe on a date, maybe, and then you just controlling it with your phone, and, like, it's just, like, y'all own little thing, like, y'all own little secret.
Yeah, and the thing about, like, I want to take out to dinner, but, you know, COVID, so that shit ain't gonna happen. So I was actually thinking about cooking for her, doing, like, a romantic dinner at the house.
Dope.
But,
Can you cook?
Barely.
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 Nigga, we got YouTube University.
Well, yeah.
Everybody should know how to cook. YouTube can tell you anything and everything.
That's the truth. But yeah, we'll look something up on YouTube. But yeah, I probably cook a romantic dinner at the house.
Keep that shit spicy. Oh, and if you're looking for sex toys, I'm actually coming out with a line. So,
what you coming out with?
I'm getting a mold. So I'm saying, if like you want to purchase one of my molds, you know what I'm saying?
Whoa, let's cut.
Oh shit.
Oh man.
Oh shit.
Nah, but no, you ain't got no plans for Valentine's Day? None?
No, bro.
No special woman? Just solo dolo?
I mean, my last Valentine's Day was terrible, so it's like I'm just trying to ride the day out.
Damn. I'm sorry.
Yeah, so it's like, it's just another day to me. Just another me day. Me day.
But I like, that's perfect. I mean, what they say, Valentine's Day is like National Singles Awareness Day.
I think it depends on the person's perspective, because I'm dope. I'm feeling good being single right now, having that freedom. I think everybody got their own thing. So it's like, if you feel like you should be in a relationship, I mean, feel like you want to be married? Hey, that's you. That's how you feel. That's how your soul works. I'm just in a good space right now that I don't have to worry about somebody else's feelings. I just have to worry about my own and how I'm feeling and take care of myself.
Yeah. All right. I guess another thing we want to talk about. You ever had somebody go through your phone before? Your cell phone? You never had a partner?
No, I've actually given my partner my phone before.
Whoa, what?
Yeah. You never done it before?
I mean, my girl know my passcode and everything to my phone, but...
I mean, I think, you know what I'm saying? Like, before you give it to them, you make sure you, like, pretty much clean it. Make sure you clean it first.
Oh, man. I mean, she could look at the text messages. I mean, you only been texting your mother and your father, but you can look at them. Oh, man.
Well, it depends, though.
What?
I think with couples or whatever... You don't really know each other until you go through each other's phones. Because I feel like your phone is like your soul in digital form. The shit that you like to look at, the shit that you like to do, the shit that you like to converse about, it's all in your phone.
Mm-hmm.
And so I feel like in a relationship, if you really into somebody, yeah, you're going to cut all of that shit off. All of that bullshit, the distractions that would deter your relationship or derail your relationship. But if you got somebody out there that's not really... fully committed to you,
mm-hmm.
they're gonna still have the riffraff on their phone.
Okay, okay.
As a supplemental purpose, purpose. So it's something that they're missing with you, or they just have their own entertainment.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree with that. I mean, even in the first situation you stated, like even if y'all were both comfortable going through each other's phone, you don't think if she went through your phone, she would see something like. If you go through somebody's phone, you're going to find something that you don't want to see, that you might not like.
Oh, yeah.
And I mean, it's either be flagrant shit, like them fuck a video of them fucking another person, or them just go like holding a casual conversation that you might think has gone on too long. So you're going to find something regardless.
Or having conversations with other bitches.
Exactly that. But nah, I just, if you go, I'm not going to say, if you, it's my thought, my idea. I mean, I might be wrong, but if you go through somebody's phone, you might as well break up with them because it's clear.
Well, going through somebody's phones, I think it just depends on the intention.
But oh, whoa,
because when I say intention, it's like, why are you going through their phone? Like, is there a lack of trust?
Well, exactly. That's my point. Like, if you might as well break up with them because you clearly don't trust them, And you cannot have a relationship if you don't trust somebody.
If you start to lose trust in somebody, it's pretty much when I think of something like that, I just hear like the like glass breaking. Like your foundation is on glass, and mm-hmm. you can hear like
cracking. The cracks. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. So it's like, just know if you're going through somebody's phone, that's the first step of the end. Because it doesn't get better any better from there, unless you don't value yourself and your time.
Yeah,
and you're really to like go through a lot of bullshit just to stick with somebody.
Exactly.
So it's like, if you value yourself and you like and like what you going through your person's phone, you find some smoke. Smoke that you was looking for. And it's a confirmation.
Exactly. What do you got a decision to make? You gonna stay?
Yeah, you can stay with that, but it's like,
are you gonna leave?
You have to weigh the options of, just know in the back of your head, like you can never fully trust them ever again. Not fully. Cause you know you've gone through their phone and like they had this, even if they apologize, it's always gonna be in the back of your head, like, we went through that shit and I found some shit. And you know, sometimes people, if they say the person apologized, hey, I was just out here doing some bullshit and mm-hmm. I didn't mean to do that. I'm gonna check that shit. That's cool, but how long would that last?
I would say if the person shows you, if the person says that they're going to change and not going to do it again, and they continue to show that change through their actions and their intentions and everything, mm-hmm. then I definitely think you can regain that level of trust again.
But you know how long it takes to regain that trust? That's eternity.
Yeah, I don't know about eternity, but definitely some time.
Just about eternity. Come on now.
Nah. So you ever had a part to go through your phone?
No, but like I said, I gave. I think.
So you never had a girl go through your phone before? Unknowingly, that you didn't want to?
Nah, of course not.
Damn, okay. All right.
Have you?
Have I had somebody go through my phone before? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But see, that's how, like, to me, when you start going through people's phones and shit, all of that doing is breathing fucking insecurity to me. And that's something I can't fucking stand insecurity.
Yeah, I would say it's a two-way street. Cause yes, she was insecure, but I could also say that I also gave her reasons to be insecure because I wasn't being transparent up front and straightforward with her.
Okay, what if you're transparent and they still have? Cause I think oftentimes you go into a relationship, you don't realize how much of the remnants you have from the past relationships.
Mm-hmm. Scars. Yeah.
That's pretty much influencing your new relationship, yep. And it's already sabotaged from the get go because the foundation was built on bullshit. And oftentimes, like, even within relationships, you jump from relationship to relationship to relationship to relationship without even healing what you've gone through in the past.
Yep, absolutely.
So it's like you can have a grade A person, like a good human being in front of you, but you'll never see it because you always have this image of being with this person who treated you so wrong. And it was all a facade. So it's like you need to really heal and have therapy, like, I advise people to do therapy, like, even if you go through a bad breakup or bad relationship, take some time to yourself.
Yep.
Because
talk to somebody.
You could have somebody that was actually for you, but then you end up sabotaging it, and then you fucked again. And it's a reoccurring thing because you never really check your foundation.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, especially going through relationship, like, take some time for yourself.
Yeah. No, like you said, even within the relationship, take some time for yourself. Don't lose yourself in the relationship. Continue to be your own strong individual, because that person wouldn't have been with you. They wouldn't have gotten into a relationship with you if you weren't the individual that you were.
Yeah.
But like I said, like, I mean, I think it's a two-way street with the going through phone stuff. Like I said, she was insecure. I did actions that led her to be insecure. Mm-hmm. So I mean, I don't take full blame for it. I mean, mm-hmm. but I could understand why she did it.
Yeah.
Nah, you ever went to a partner's home before? Unknowingly?
Nah. The thing is, when I get to that point, it's time for me to upgrade. Because you know how I feel about relationships. I think they should be on the lease terms.
Okay.
Nah, because I feel like oftentimes that's extra energy. It's extra negative energy that you're putting into your relationship. So even if, let's say you don't find anything in that moment, that's not going to be the first or the last time you start checking their phones.
True. Definitely true. Definitely true.
Because, I mean, if you feel something, just like if the woman felt something with you that maybe you weren't being as honest with her on mm-hmm. certain things, she had a certain vibe, certain energy that she needed to check your phone. So it's like, it just won't be that moment. It's going to be a reoccurring thing probably throughout your entire relationship.
Yep.
So, and then as a man or the opposite person to go through that same thing, it's like, bro, it's like a broken record. I don't want to be in this no more. Get out the fucking loop.
Yeah, and again, like, it's just a continual loop, and then it's really just how much of the shit are you willing to take before you really, I guess, value or see the value in yourself and decide to move on.
Yeah, so I'm saying, like,
otherwise you like Joaquin Phoenix with putting the fucking Joker the Joker makeup on your face in the mirror and shit.
A fucking clown. Nah, I mean, I think, yeah, we care about each other, but everybody has that breaking point. And like I said, if you value yourself, like if you didn't have any self-esteem or self-confidence, you're probably just sticking it like, it's probably the best shit I can get. Let me just continue to do this shit. But if you value yourself and you see yourself as like, listen, I got you. I can get somebody else. I know my worth.
No, man, that's the bar. Just know your worth.
Yeah, know your worth.
Know your worth. And again, Delta, goddamn, going back to this kind of domestic violence. Not like this is like verbal domestic violence. Like you'll get the partner say like, you can't do better than me. Nobody else will love you like I love you. That's a lie.
Nobody.
Hey, shout out Key Sweat.
Nah, they only saying that shit out of reflection of themselves, and they hold themselves to high regard, even if they could be toxic.
Exactly. You are good enough to be loved by anybody in the world. Don't let nobody tell you that shit.
Yeah. So it's like I said, everybody has their breaking point. But I think people would do more to avoid pain than to gain pleasure.
I mean, what is like painful truths and unpleasant lies? It's like,
yeah, you don't want to hear it. Like, you know, some shit is going on, but you don't want to see it. You don't want to hear it until you get to the point. You're like, no, I have to see what I've been thinking is going on.
Yeah, man,
I have to face it. And that's when you know that you are a strong person. The person is, I feel like it's weak if they never want to check it. But I know he out there doing this. I know she out there doing that. I couldn't do it. Because then you have to take in consideration of like with the person, especially you've been intimate with and being close. If you're in a deep relationship, you probably not using a lot of contraceptives or condoms or whatever. Like you probably really close to each other. Close. So it's like you putting your body in their hands.
Yeah.
Because even with a relationship that's good and healthy and a good foundation, you respect and love each other enough to not to bring in any outside forces that would affect your significant other.
Yeah.
So it's like you got to take their health into consideration. And then when you, like what I was trying to say is, when you going to look through that phone and shit, and then you might find some shit. Let's say you find some shit. Now you got to take a step back like, oh, they was messing around with this other person and they put in my fucking health in jeopardy. And there's a lot of shit out there beyond COVID where it's like when you look at that, when you look at that line, like I got to protect myself because I don't know, like niggas out here, you know what I'm saying, going raw and doing all this shit. And he come back and like, maybe I might suck his dick, but I'm sucking his dick. He ain't even washed out because he got some other bitches pussy on there.
Nah, but I feel like today there was like a stigmatism around STDs that, like, that's not there anymore, if that makes sense.
How like, you figure?
Nah, because, you know, like, when we was growing up, and when I was growing up, I mean, shit, you know, they're much older than me. But when I was growing up, bro, like, the thought again, like, HIV.
Oh, yeah.
That shit scared the fuck out of me. Like, I stopped fucking for a period of time because I was so afraid of that shit.
My mom's a nurse. And, like, she would come home telling us different stories.
Bro.
She would come on telling us different stories of, like, the patients that she would have to, you know what I'm saying, care for. And, like, have women in there come in with, like, the pussy deformed and shit. Like, got everything and anything on it. Or, like, the dude, he has his dick, like, falling off because he been around here fucking around with different women.
Oh, boy.
Could have been men or whatever. And it's, like, that kind of, like, scared me. So, it's, like, I kept myself for a long time.
Yeah.
I wasn't out here like that. And I'm still not out here like that. I'm chilling. But I'm always mindful. I'm never fucking reckless.
Yeah.
Not with my health and my body.
But I was going to say, like, today, like I said, the thought of, like, getting HIV today, like, it scared the fuck out of me. But I feel like people today, and I probably say, like, maybe young people to a certain extent, like, young people today, bro, they're not afraid of HIV. Like, they really think it was, like, a common cold. Like,
Russian roulette out here.
Yeah, I mean, like, they'll catch it, they'll take the pills, and they'll be fine. And yeah. Man, like, just that mentality is scary as fuck.
And I went to this place called, it's down the street, this place called Out the Closet. And it's like a thrift store type, but it's within the community. It don't matter if you're lesbian, gay, straight, or whatever. Like, they actually do free HIV testing.
Okay, bet. That's what's up.
And I just go to, I had, I went with my ex. I was just checking out. She knew of it. You know what I'm saying? Both of us are health conscious, get tested or whatever. Mm-hmm. And so we went, and I was like, it was so eye-opening. But he was saying, like, he'll have people come in and get tested. And it was actually, he was administering the test, and he's actually a gay guy. He was like, oftentimes we are dealing with different people. What he'll do is he'll tell the guy that, hey, I'll still fuck with you if you, like, non-detectable or whatever. Because mm-hmm. he said they take certain shit that it makes...
Their viral load so low that
yeah, it's undetectable. Undetectable. And then the guy will come out and tell him, oh, yeah, yeah. And he's like, nah, I can't fuck with you. It's a little test that he give him.
Damn.
So what? He pretty much like...
Why?
Gotcha, bitch.
You know what I'm saying? He like,
gotcha, bitch.
Denied.
Wow.
So that's it's like that's being smart, though.
Mm-hmm.
Cause it's a lot of shit out here.
Yeah,
so
that's smart.
I never knew that you can have shit that you can take that and make shit undetectable.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's crazy shit out here.
I mean, shit. Magic Johnson got that shit, or we got the cure for it. One of the two.
He been here so long. I don't think he got shit right now.
I mean, you know what the rumor is? The rumor is they don't really got it. Nah, I tell you this joke that my uncle told me back in the day. He was talking about he said Magic didn't really have HIV. They said Magic Johnson was very well endowed,
mm-hmm.
and that he had actually killed a couple of them.
Killed a couple of what?
Just killed a couple of them. And David Stern in the NBA was like, bro, we can't keep covering this shit up, bro. You got to get the fuck out the league.
What? Really?
Nah, but that's the rumor. That's the rumor about Magic Johnson.
Damn. Like, you asked him just like... Before he left the Lakers or whatever, he had an interview, and he had made that face.
I
ain't gonna be here.
Exactly.
The same thing with HIV. I ain't got it. Some shit like that. Like,
oh, man. But nah, man, that shit is hilarious. That was a funny story. Shout out my uncle, RIP, man.
Oh, RIP. Damn, that is crazy.
But now, what next? What was I talking about? Oh, I know you wanted to elaborate on your coming of age story, dancing. And drugs and alcohol.
Dancing and drugs and alcohol. I ain't never did no drugs. I do hookah. That's about it. But I ain't no fucking crackhead in this bitch. No, I was thinking. I was talking to one of my best friends named Rod, and we was having a conversation. We was out at.
Shout out, Rod.
What's up, Rod?
Come on the podcast.
Stop being so fucking scared. And we was having a conversation, and he was like, "Yeah, listen to the pod or whatever." And then like I just had a fucking thought. It was a memory. I was like, it's crazy how we all have memories, but they like buried under other memories. And it takes a trigger for you to have them to come back out to the surface. And so I was talking to him. I was like, yeah, last pod I talked about how when I went to college or whatever, and I was out at, I went at West Georgia at the time. My whole story about my first time drinking.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't tell, because there's a cause and effect. What was the cause of wanting me to go drink? That night. Like, why did I wanted to go drink that yeah. night? So basically the story is and I presented
story time.
I present it like this. I think every man has shit that he goes through that it makes him like nut up or like boss up.
Definitely.
And I think like every man has taken so many L's that you'll never see. You know what I'm saying? But it makes him a stronger person. I think women go through the same shit too.
Yeah, yeah.
And so my cause and effect, the reason I wanted to go drink and party that night is because, let me tell you the story. So I had this girl I was talking to, and we was just friends with her. I think we was just study partners or whatever. But I was sweet on her, as old school would say. I was sweet on her. I liked her.
I like you, and I want you.
I like you, and I want you. And so we was texting back and forth. So I kind of just shot my shot. And she was texting back, and we was actually supposed to meet up at her dorm right one night. And I was like, oh, shit, it's about to go down.
Okay.
This is what's up. I'm in the end game now.
Gotcha, bitch.
And I was like, we started texting. She was texting back. I'm like, damn, she with it. So what I do is I go and get ready. I hop in the shower. I'm in the fucking dormitory. You know what I'm saying?
I know.
Hop in the shower. Wash my shower. I want everything to be fucking like fucking fresh.
No, shave all that good stuff.
I don't think I was shaving at the time. Manscaping came toward the latter part of my life.
Okay.
So I'm like, I'm taking extra time, like really getting all the nooks and crannies. I want shit to be right. You know what I'm saying?
I understand.
The cologne and shit going everywhere. Like I want my shit to be like A1. I want it to be sparkling. I want my balls to be fresh. I'm in the shower, like put on. I'm about to head over because we was on campus, so I just walked over to a dormitory. And I'm fresh and clean, but I'm comfortable fresh and clean. Cause you like if you're really trying to get it in, you can really tell if people are trying to get it in. Like they dress comfortably. Like if you're going over a shorty's place, you're not dressing in a 3-piece suit. You probably dressing in some sweats or something.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Easy access.
So I can get in and get the fuck up out of this shit. You know what I'm saying?
If it could be rip away, it'd be rip away.
Yeah, exactly. And so I think I had on some sweats at the time. I don't think it was shorts. It was cold at the time. I'm saying it was a cold night. And so I walked to the dormitory, get up to her room or whatever, knock on the door. I'm so fucking excited. You know what I'm saying? Like, you just see, like, me cheesing. You know what I'm saying? Cheesing. And I open up the door, and there's actually a group of women in there.
Okay. Okay. What we about to get into?
Nah, nigga, that ain't how it went down. It was more like,
what the fuck?
Because I got in there. I thought she was alone because she told me in the text she was alone or whatever. So in my mind, I'm like, oh my God, look at all of these fucking cock blocks. I'm like, I'm trying to be with her. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And so I get in there, I walk in, and she looking like she wasn't really expecting me. And come to find out, it was her friend on the bed. She was actually the one that was texting me. It wasn't her. So basically, I got fucking played that night.
So what her friend trying to do though?
No, it was like a joke.
What, bruh?
It was a fucking joke.
Man.
So no, I'm fucking embarrassed. I'm like embarrassed. Nah, I was like,
bruh, just wow, bruh, that's some fuck shit right there.
I'm fucking embarrassed as shit. And I'm like, I didn't stay there alone. I probably was there like about 5 minutes. But I felt like this small. You know what I'm saying? Like embarrassed. Like my fucking dick was out. Like if I would have showed up to the room, like I would have had my dick out with a banana or some. What if I would have had like a house coat or some shit? Like I'm ready to drop some dick off, right? But I was like, so that's what I'm saying. Like, we men take a lot of fucking L's. And it's like, it's all about how you respond to them L's. Cause with me, like, I never really didn't have any confidence. Well, I've never been a person that didn't have confidence. I have confidence, but you have other people. Like, say if like you intel or whatever, mm-hmm. they take shit harder than that. Like, oh yeah. My god, she didn't want to give me the pussy or whatever. I'm gonna fucking kill everybody.
That's loser shit.
Hell no,
that's loser.
No, bro. I took that L, and I don't think I ever talked to her ever again. Like after that. At that point, you know what I'm saying? And it just taught me just a valuable lesson. And that was the catalyst for me. I was like, I felt so low. I went back to my boys and told them a story like, oh, Vert, damn, that shit happened, bro. Man, fuck that bitch. And then we went out, we partied that night. So that was the reason
Damn, that night birthed a monster. The Verticus.
I ain't never been the same since. And like, bro, that's what I'm saying. It's a cause and effect for everything. And it's like, no matter what you go through, there's always a reason for you going through shit. Whether it's relationships, breakups, or whatever, it's going to make you stronger.
Mm. Man.
It's going to make you stronger.
And like you say, I mean,
you got to get through it.
Men, people in general, bro, you take so many L's in life trying to find just somebody that you could to really just fuck with.
Yeah.
Man.
So it's
bad. I got some stories that I don't even know if I can share right now.
But shit, we gonna be on the pod for a minute, so it's like, bro, we got plenty of time to like go down memory lane. But that was really what triggered me from, you know what I'm saying, going out to have an epic night where I blacked out and all of that shit, and I'm jumping off balconies and shit. That was the catalyst for that.
Right, man. But I got a story for next time. At stories about a girl, she was only talking to me because she was trying to fuck with my nigga. And my nigga was going to the league. But that's a story for next time.
Listen, I think we talked about a lot of shit, but I think we should end it there. And just say, like, listen, whatever you're going through, this is only temporary. we all take L's. We all take L's in private that we really don't share. Me, I just don't give a fuck. I feel like maybe somebody else is going through that shit. And it's a story in my past, like fucking 10, 12 years ago. But it's like, I wouldn't be the person I am today if I haven't gone through all the shit that I've gone through. So I'm very, like, thankful that I've gone through even the bullshit. Because it molds you in a certain way that you move in a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
You find your worth and your purpose and everything. So, y'all, like, if you're going through some shit right now, this is only temporary. Troubles don't last always. Mm-hmm. So we're going to end with that shit.
Yeah. Hey! Hey! Hey, thank y'all for listening to another episode of The Real Creators Collab.
Woo! Woo!
Man, it was real therapeutic. LeBert was in his bag. Hey, one more time. I'm going to do it. You ready?
Yeah.
Hey. You down with RCC?
Yeah, you know we.
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 Until next time, y'all.
We out.